Hello, welcome to the trailer of my graduation project. My name is Hasan Mutlu. My subject is hardware Trojan detection using delay-based method on FPGA. A hardware Trojan is a modification in a computer hardware that can be used to perform harmful tasks. One way to detect hardware Trojans is by looking for these unusual delays. The first aim of this project is detecting how the delay values change when we add a Trojan hardware on top of a Verilog design on an FPGA. We have six example paths, single path 1, 2 and 3. Also we have the Trojan edit versions of the single path 3. The first part of this project will be mainly based on comparing the measurement results of this one clean path and its two Trojan edit versions. For in order to make their difference more obvious, these paths are duplicated and chained multiple times. By this way, the delay difference between them are multiplied by a factor. We have two state machines for delay measurements. One is for measuring low to high delay and the other is for high to low delay. The state machine is made up of three states. In the first state, the initial input is given to the path and is waited to produce this input as output. Then the given input is inversed and is waited to produce the new output. During this waiting process, a counter is incremented at every clock edge. Inside the data path module of the state machines, every duplicated versions of paths are present. The path that will be measured is commented out in this file. In the top module, the module for the type of the delay to be measured is commented out. This module contains the state machine and it sends the results to the decimal to 7 segment unit to display it on the FPGA device. Let's measure the delays of the 50 times duplicated single path 3 and one of its Trojan edit versions, and let's see if we can capture some difference between them. The result of the single path 3 is found to be 97, and let's program it for its Trojan edit version. Let's program the device. And the result is found as 105. As you can see, there is a difference between the delay values of these two modules, and we can say that the PiPath 3.1 is a suspicious path. It might include some Trojan hardware inside it. The second objective of this project is detecting how much the delay values change due to the in-chip variations of the device by placing the Verilog design on different parts of the layout. In order to place the design on different parts, its 8 copies are placed on the chip at the same time. Each of them are placed with their own state machines and counters as well. The switches on the FPGA device are used to direct one of these 8 copies result to the display module. In order to do this, the 3 switches are adjusted to choose one of them, and then the device is programmed. The compilation is finished. Now, before programming the device, we adjust the 3 switches on the right to select one of them. I now select the first one and let's see what is the delay of the first one. It is 96. Now I change the switch and choose the second one and program the device again. And it's 97. Again, I program the device. Now it's 97. The test results show that there are some minimal differences in delays of these 8 copies of the designs, and this proves that placing the design on different parts on the device does make a difference on the delay values. However, we are still not sure if it is caused by the in-chip variations. In order to detect this more clearly, further research is needed. Thank you for listening.